glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. You're getting a live look at the final moments before kickoff of the Meineke Car Care Bowl of Texas. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
And we're just about set to kick off. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game.
Here we go.
Taken down in the backfield.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
Down and 11. Ball on 24.
Ready. Green on five.
Fumble. Loose ball. Picks up the fumble.
He makes it to the 25-yard line. Up only about 2 yards with that grab. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Here we go!
And he's taken down right around the 14-yard line.
The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play.
They should continue to run the ball. If they keep this up, the defense will wear down very quickly.
Here we go. Green 19.
There he goes.
Makes it out to about the 29.
Get him in the backfield. How about the play of this defensive end.
This is just solid run defense here. They get a great push up front, not allowing the runner to have much room to work with. And at the end, they're able to wrap him up.
Here we go. Green 19.
He's tackled at the 37.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
It all. Tackle around the 19-yard line. And that play could have gone for six.
Oh, boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about how they were going to dominate these receivers. I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash. Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
Pitches out and the ball is up for grabs. He's taken down at the 19.
I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. Set. Red 18. Red 18.
Here they come. And he's tackled around the 14-yard line. Made around the 4-yard line.
You know, Brad, that's the second third down that they've been able to convert on this drive. And this offense right now has really showed a lot of poise and been able to hold on to the football and try to maintain this drive.
Brought down around the 1-yard line.
That is great, tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
Very important. Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Wisconsin is up by four. He's scrambling. He gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
credit those two defenses in that first quarter or blame the offenses for a lack of production. Wisconsin leads 7-3. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
The defense forced a turnover on downs on the last drive.
Hey, remember, you don't have to go for it on fourth down. The last time you had the football, you went for it on fourth down, and you didn't convert. Just think about this. If you move the ball into your opponent's territory and you want to take a chance and it makes sense to go for it on fourth down, I understand that, and I get it. But when you're in your own territory and it's fourth down and five or longer, just considering a punt would make me so happy.
They'll bring him down at the 50-yard line.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
Quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
And they make the stop at the 14-yard line. Wisconsin holds a 4-point lead. For the tight end, but they can't hook up.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Gets to about the 24-yard line. Makes it out to about the 39. Wisconsin is up four. The ball. Here's an opening. He's at midfield. Very clutch tackle there because this kid had some space. There's a flag down, and it looks this like this one's coming back.
Clipping. Offense.
That one's going to put him way back.
You just can't block a player from behind like that, or it's going to cost you.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He makes his way to about the 48. Run up the middle.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll make it
two times. Two times.
Ready. Red 18. Red 18.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Complete for 6 yards, and that's good for a first down.
Heads-up play by the quarterback to find his receiver in traffic and get the ball into his hands.
Wisconsin is up by four.
Ready! Green 19! Green 19!
He's under pressure. And he is drilled at the 40-yard line.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
Set, green 19, green 19.
He's out of bounds at the 40. So another third down here, and this time it's third and long. And he tackles him hard at the 30. This kid just doesn't stop. That's his second sack of the game.
Yeah, that's two sacks today for this defensive end. He's really showed up and played the type of game you'd expect from him.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Wisconsin holds a four-point lead. Sails it long. Doesn't get there.
It's third down and 11 to go. Ball on their own 24. Wants it all. Going deep. Incomplete. We've played a half of football here. Wisconsin's up by four.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This game's been everything we anticipated it being. Each team matching each other blow for blow. Just a one-possession game at this point. What do you expect to change things in the second half?
Well, it's always fun to watch two teams and two gangs match up the hype. And we talk about it all week and how big this game is. And it's going to come down to players making plays. And, you know, the big play is something that we continue to beat into the ground. And which one doesn't give that up? A lot of times, you know, games are lost and won by turnovers and giving it away and making that crucial mistake. You can do everything right and you can execute right, but it just takes that one misstep, that one turnover to really put you in a bad position or a bad situation that can determine this game. That's what it looks like it's going to. Both teams executing well. Who's going to make a big mistake?
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Great first half. Hopefully the second half's as good. Fields it at the 7. Got the corner. Knocked out of bounds. The 33-yard line. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Wisconsin is up 4. About the 33-yard line. So he decides to hold on to it, and that's going nowhere.
He really did a nice job of anticipating the run and making the play on the ball carrier.
Gets out to around the 48. At the 40. He's pushed out of bounds at the 29.
First down here, Brad, by this offense. The receiver's running the football. You got to think, as a defensive coordinator, it's one thing to try to defend and kind of your traditional offensive attack, but here you got to start worrying about what is this wide receiver going to do. It puts a lot of pressure on the defense and the defensive mindset on how they want to try to slow this offense down.
At the 20, and he's taken down at about the 19-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 24-yard line. Wisconsin is up by 4.
Here we go. Right 80. Right 80.
He's tackled around the 23-yard line.
Keep
looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. The kick is up, and it's good. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
10-3, Wisconsin. Squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Lewis picks up about 4 yards after keeping the ball on the option. Yeah, we got an injured player on the field. From their own 20-yard line. It's second down.
Here we go, here we go.
Set, right
in. And he's tackled right around the 30. About the 29-yard line.
I like how the defense got all up into that option to disrupt it. The offense looks a bit unsettled after losing that battle.
Wisconsin holds a 4-point lead. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. And he shoved out of bounds at the 44. Well, player down, and his teammates obviously worried after that play. From the 44-yard line, first down. Gains his way to the 36-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. So the Badgers lost a player to an earlier injury, and unfortunately, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to come back today. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
Wisconsin is up 4.
Truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. Strike to his receiver, no good.
It's a first down here, and I love to see the wide receiver get a chance to get his hands on the football. You know, the offensive coordinator told us earlier this week they're going to do everything they can to get this receiver involved in the game plan, whether it means catching a ball or at times running the football. And there, he shows what he can do with the football in his hand.
He's taken down around the 36-yard line. Made at about the 21.
Offensive coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the fifth first down on this drive alone. The big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
A perfect play call. They look like they practiced that one a few times.
And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
The offensive line got a really good push there, allowing the back to pick up 9 on the play. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. And he carries the ball for a nice game. To the halfback, gets 6 yards. The Horned Frogs will use their first time out of the half. So it's second down now. Check, they check. Need about 4 yards regular, to pick up the regular, first.
Regular.
And they'll bring him down behind the line. 1 yard loss for the halfback. TCU will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
They're going to come up short here on this third down. The defensive line did a great job of getting some penetration, and the overall defensive effort was big there to set up this fourth down.
They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, and it's off the crossbar. No good. And that's as close as you can get without making the kick.
When he first kicked it, I thought it looked good, but he literally just was inches away from putting that thing through.
So we're just about ready to return to action.
Right here, right here. Hey, check.
Just under two to go in the game.
Let's go!
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
So it's second and ten. Ball on the 27-yard line. Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Makes this a fourth and very long. They'll bring him down at about the 45. The spike will stop the clock. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45.
I can't believe they let you play.
Steps up, looking for his man, incomplete. He
throws right. And they make the stop around the 33-yard line. This is the 10th play of the drive. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 22. And they'll try one last pass here to pad the stats, but that's about all they're going to get right here. He's looking for six. We're at the 12th play of the drive. And he's right there to knock it away. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, Wisconsin 24, TCU 12. As we wrap this game up, Kirk, what final thoughts do you want to share?
I thought this would have been a little closer than the scoreboard indicates. Maybe that says something about how good a game they played. Wisconsin had a really tough matchup coming in, but they were prepared, motivated, and came away with a really solid win.
Here's a look at today's player of the game. For Wisconsin, they win another one late in the season, giving them an 8-5 record. And for the Horned Frogs, they drop below 500 on the season with today's loss.